अगर भगवान ने मेरे को पूछा, पूछेगा कभी भी क्या तुम क्या बोलना चाहते हो, तो मैं वो 97 का वो जो फेडरेशन कप का सेमीफाइनल मैच मैं बोलना चाहूंगा.
Bhaichung goes past the defender and the goalkeeper has come out. Bhaichung suddenly literally acts that he falls.
All yeah. the three players were not prepared. The goalkeeper was not prepared. It went straight in the second post.
ऐसा नहीं था कि बैरेटो ही मैच जिताया था. Bhaichung भी एकदम 50-50 कंट्रीब्यूशन था दोनों का.
I have a big regret in my life and that is hurting me a lot.
Bhaichung Bhutia is really something else. He can create something out of nothing, and that is the hallmark of real genius. To conjure up magic, here is the magic. The Romario of Indian football. Out of a narrow opening, he can score the most incredible goals. The most brilliant player in Indian football for many, many years.
Arey Trisha, it's been so many days that our promo on Bhaichung has released. So I've been trying to call you about the episode. I'm messaging you. What's the problem?
The problem actually is there's a lot of network issue. And this has started from the day, you know, the Amphan cyclone. It has caused havoc, you know, in Kolkata, all over West Bengal. And the destruction level, although it was so scary at home, you know, with the wind was blowing so, it was at 130 kilometers per hour. And, you know, our neighbors' windows and all were shattered. It was, it has caused havoc. You have seen pictures, you know, waterlogging everywhere. Amphan has destroyed everything. It was a mass destruction, you know.
This destruction I have seen in the news and, it's a very sad news for all the Absolutely. People who have been affected by it. And no offense Absolutely. To anyone, but this is a destruction which is a very bad news for the people. But Absolutely. The same kind of destruction somebody used to bring for the opponents. And that's the iconic superstar of Indian football, whom we are going to discuss about today, is Bhaichung Bhutia. So again, no offense to anyone. But
Absolutely.
The destruction level was same. And I remember it was 1996-1997. You always needed a spark from someone to start watching start following a sport. And Bhaichung was the man who gave that spark for me, at least. Because he was someone who was called Pahari Biche. I didn't know what Pahari Biche meant. It means mountain scorpion. And it had the sting. And Bhaichung had the sting and the viciousness in his football. And that's why he was called Pahari Biche during 1996 and before that. And that's why I came to know about Bhaichung Bhutia.
He was also known as Sikkimi Sniper, you know, because his shots towards the goal went like the bullets from Rajnikant's movie, you know.
And see, because we have a special person to discuss today, we have two special guests starting with the one who is on your screen. See, like a perfect team man carrying the balls for his team, ex-Indian captain Debjit Ghosh, East Bengal and Mohunbagan footballer, who is often called Defense Ka Don, but also he used to rule the midfield.
And not to forget, the live wire in the wings. Soumitra Chakraborty, the ex-East Bengal and Mohunbagan player, he seems to be giving a lot of advices to Bhaichung Bhutia, right? We will take some notes from him today as well.
So, today's Adda will be about Bhaichung Bhutia, obviously with Debjit and Soumitra Da. But I want to take you back to 1997 and those days. How I became a East Bengal fan. Just generally, people become an East Bengal or Mohunbagan fan by birth. But it was not the same for me, because Bhaichung was someone who was very good at bicycle kicks for India and all the teams he has played in. He has continuously tried and executed this bicycle kick very efficiently. And I don't remember the exact game, but he was playing for East Bengal during that period, 97-96. And I saw him perform this bicycle kick, which just went off the target. But it was so great to see. It seemed that he did something which was not normal. It was not the same things which the other people were doing on the pitch. And that moment clicked. That moment stayed in my memory for many years. And that's how I thought, ki, aray, ye player koi khas player hoga. मतलब कुछ अलग ही कर रहा है ये.
Well, the bicycle kick story is rather embarrassing as far as I am concerned. Okay, I don't know if I should share this with you all or not, but ठीक है, चलता है, अपनों के बीच में चलता है, right? So first time when I saw Bhaichung playing bicycle kick, I had actually never seen that before, because back then you didn't have a lot of TV coverage as such, right? So when I first saw Bhaichung playing the bicycle kick, I thought probably he fell down. Okay, he was falling down behind, so his leg, you know, just stood up and by chance it hit the ball, and that was a very good execution somehow. And my father was like, are you serious? That's like a very good shot. That's like a unique shot. That's called bicycle kick. He didn't do it by mistake. It's a very embarrassing story. But yeah, that's how I got to know about bicycle kick. I mean, nowadays we see it's very common. But back then, yeah. Bhaichung is the trendsetter of bicycle kicks, as far as I am concerned. As far as I am concerned, I'm not...
Yeah. At least in Indian football. But I want to bring in Debjit da here. So Trisha embarrassed herself at that point of time. But tell me something, Debjit da. You have played in the same team with Bhaichung and also played as an opponent. So how was those days? How was the experience of those days? How was the memories of those days?
हम लोगों का टाइम पे दो स्ट्राइकर जो इंडियन में था, एक बाईचुंग एक आई एम बीजन, दोनों को लेके ज़्यादा परेशान होने वाला था. सबको मालूम है, सब डिफेंडर को मालूम है ये. तो बाईचुंग को लेके, क्योंकि इनसाइड का बॉक्स बाईचुंग बहुत फेरोसस था, उसका रिफ्लेक्स अच्छा था, सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी छोटा बोल के, इसीलिए ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा ध्यान देना पड़ता था. लेकिन जब मेरा टीम पे खेला, एक साथ खेला, जब मेरा टीम मेट था, तब एक अलग सा मतलब क्या होता है, अलग सा कम्फर्ट जोन जो है ना स्ट्राइकिंग फोर्स में, कुछ भी बॉल 50-50 बॉल 60-40 बॉल उसको डाल दो, सिर्फ गोल कर देगा. तो उसको लेके दोनों तरह का मेरे को मेमोरीज है. एक जब मेरा ओपोनेंट में खेलता था तब उसको लेके जो परेशान वाला जो मेमोरीज, और जब मेरा टीम में खेलता था तब दूसरा जो अलग सा सुकून मिलता था उसका साथ खेलने खेल के.
पर मुझे तो बहुत सुकून मिला था जब 1997 फेडरेशन कप सेमीफाइनल में बाईचुंग ने हैट्रिक स्कोर कर दिया मोहन बगान के खिलाफ. You must be remembering the match, no, Orgo?
Oh my God, that was a great day. I remember our place was fully packed. Like, there were so many people were watching that match together, and I was surrounded by Mohun Bagan fans. East Bengal Mohun Bagan were playing in front of record crowd, more than
120,000.
Yeah. And I remember the atmosphere in our house, it was totally, so people were chanting,
it was like a stadium
and all that. And I was the only one supporting East Bengal, and I was being trolled and all that. And I remember after the match ended and throughout the match, there was pin drop silence. I was the one who was shouting.
No doubt.
Because Bhaichung has scored. And there's an unofficial term in football, that perfect hat trick, where you score the goal by head, right foot and the leg foot, and Bhaichung's hat trick was actually that. So
right.
It was domination that day, and that will, I think, stay as an iconic match for centuries, I guess.
अगर भगवान ने मेरे को पूछा, पूछेगा कभी भी, क्या तुम क्या बोलना चाहते हो, तो मैं वो 97 का वो जो फेडरेशन कप का सेमीफाइनल मैच मैं बोलना चाहूंगा, क्योंकि वो एक्चुअली बाईचुंग का मैच था. एक्चुअली वो डिफरेंस क्रिएट कर दिया. ज्यादा चांस क्रिएट नहीं हुआ, इस बंगल ज्यादा चांस क्रिएट नहीं किया, लेकिन तब भी जो चांस में वो स्कोर किया, एक्चुअली वो छोड़ के दूसरा कोई भी स्ट्राइकर उस टाइम में इंडिया में वो नहीं कर सकता था, क्योंकि जो चांस मिला वो 60-40-70-30 रेशियो था, उसका ऊपर वो कन्वर्ट करके निकल गया.
वो एक दिन बाईचुंग का था, पर पता है, ऑब्वियसली आई एम वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट फैंस ऑफ बाईचुंग भुटिया, लाइक मोस्ट ऑफ अस इंडियंस, राइट. पर ऐसा एक दिन था जब मैंने ये प्रे किया था कि बाईचुंग का दिन ना, गेस व्हिच डे, ऑब्वियसली बरी एफसी अगेंस्ट मैन्यू. I was hoping and praying ki please yaar Bhaichung acha na khele, but Bhaichung acha khela tha, thankfully score nahi kiya tha. Aur sirf usi din kyun, Bhaichung ne acha khela tha har din, the day, every day he was fantastic.
True. Aur Buddy FC mein jab chala gaya Bhaichung around 1999, he was in East Bengal before that. So at that time I was like utna zyada newspaper mein nahi padhta tha and all that. So I knew Bhaichung was in East Bengal player and suddenly I figured out that he is not in East Bengal. So kahan gaya? India mein to hai nahi. So chala kahan gaya Bhaichung? And then I found out that he has gone to Buddy FC, which was Division 2 at that point of time in the English league tier, which was the third tier in that. So, and I thought, hey, this is the great news. So, well, obviously, I didn't see the live matches. Those were not obviously telecasted in India. But then I figured out some of the videos and he was fantastic in those games. The few games which he played, around 36, 46 games he played, and he was amazing. He started those games. He was one of the main players for Buddy FC. And that new injury he had during that stint, during the third year of that stint, the last year, I think that hampered his stint a lot. I think he could have done much more in English football. Maybe, I don't know whether in English Premier League or not, but in some lower divisions, he could have played really good football. But that knee injury really hampered his stint.
Acha, when you talk about knee injury and when we talk about Bhaichung specially, main ek sawal karna chahti hu aaj hamare do special guests se ki according to Debjit da as well as Soumitra da, aapko aap logo ko kya lagta hai ki Bhaichung ki strength kya thi? I mean exactly kyun wo itne logo se alag tha ya itna dangerous tha?
मैं जो नोटिस किया उसके बारे में, उसका जो स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉइंट है एज ए प्लेयर वो है मेंटल स्ट्रेंथ। बहुत सेल्फ बिलीव करता था, छोटा से ड्रीम था उसका। जब कलकत्ता आया उसी टाइम वो एकदम अपने आप ठीक कर लिया था कि इंडिया का बेस्ट प्लेयर बनना है और वो बन के दिखाए।
मेरे को लगता है एक एक प्लेयर 18-19 साल ये सर्किट में, टॉप इंडिया का सर्किट में एक कंटिन्यूअसली खेलना, ये बहुत बड़ा चीज है। क्योंकि हम लोगों का टाइम में फॉरेनर भी बहुत अच्छा अच्छा फॉरेनर था। आई लीग का जो प्रेशर था वो अलग सा प्रेशर था। इसमोन मुनमान का जो प्रेशर था वो ज्यादा लेना पड़ता है क्योंकि हम लोग ज्यादा इसमोन मुनमान के लिए खेला है, तो उसके लिए जो प्रेशर। और Bhaichung Bhutia का जो भी टीम बनाएगा, जो भी फॉरेनर रहेगा, Bhaichung अगर रहेगा तो किसी भी कोच, किसी भी सपोर्टर, किसी भी ऑफिशियल, किसी भी प्लेयर कॉलिग जो हम लोग था, सभी हम लोग उसका ऊपर डिपेंड करता था। तो उसका अलग सा प्रेशर था, वो प्रेशर
Debjit, Bhaichung, I think, was born to handle pressure, and we saw that in the 2003 Asean Club Championship.
Actually, foreigner Mike Douglas, Musa ko rakhte hue bhi, mere ko ye lagta hai, Asean jo mila hai, maybe 20-25% credit goes to Bhaichung Bhutia.
Ekdam sahi baat ki ne kiya apne, kyunki Bhaichung ne 2003 में he had come back to East Bengal from Mohun Bagan and 2002-03 में East Bengal were NFL champions. They were a good team, but when Bhaichung came back, the team became more stronger. And I remember those were the days I was back reading newspapers. So I kept a lot of information.
Bhaichung came to East Bengal, you came to newspapers. Yes.
So I remember that the East Bengal team with Subhash Bhoumik as a coach. Like I am talking as if Debjit was in that team, and I am saying, giving all the information
exactly.
Now. But still, I say that they were kept in a great hotel in Kolkata, and they were really training for this tournament, Asean Club Championship, and they were all ready to make a good impact in that tournament. So there was this noise that. Around East Bengal, that a strong team from India is going to represent the country at a international level. And in the first match, I remember against Bekhtero Susana was the runners-up of the Asian Champions League.
Which
by the way, FC Goa will play for the first time next season.
He was. You're giving anecdotes also now in our show.
So, okay, getting they were the point, champions. Yeah. They were really tough opponents, and
absolutely.
I remember East Bengal were given so many bad decisions in the first match. They
exactly.
lost.
Exactly, I was about to say. You remember? I think refereeing in that tournament was ridiculous.
Two out was really bad, and from that moment, from there on, from the second game till the final, Bhaichung scored at least one goal in every match. Second game against Philippine Army, six goals, double hat trick. Then the next match, again a goal. And then the next match, again he scored a very important goal. So every day I opened the papers, because again, I was not seeing the matches live. I opened the papers and I saw Bhaichung's name was on the score sheet. I thought, like, he was a great player in the Indian circuit, but against a foreign team, he was really great against the Indonesian clubs in the quarterfinal and then in the semifinal to Indonesian clubs. He was great. And then when they reached the finals, I must say, I and many other Indian football fans didn't think that East Bengal would reach the final of that tournament.
Absolutely. I'm that sure. I'm sure most of us didn't think so. Most of the East Bengal fans weren't. I mean, we didn't expect, right?
Yeah, they were a great team. Maybe the best team in the Indian football circuit back then. But still, to reach the final and again, Bektero Sasana, the runners-up of AFC Champions League was in the final. And it was time for a revenge. And I remember that was a match which I saw live. I remember because I had to see it. How can I miss that match? And East Bengal were leading 1-0 at halftime. But again, 1-0 is a very, what you can say, it's a very scary scoreline. And just at the start of the second half, Bhaichung takes this ball down the right wing. He goes past one of the footballers, one of the players, and enters the box. Goalkeeper comes out. And it seems that he falls down, but he doesn't. He takes the ball. He takes full control of the ball. He dodges past the goalkeeper and calmly puts inside the net. Oh my God, that goal
gave
me so much joy.
You know, I'll tell you what happened. So when Bhaichung goes past the defender and the goalkeeper has come out, you obviously know the situation. Bhaichung suddenly literally acts that he falls. And here I am sitting and watching the match. I have literally got up from my, chair and I've tried to like hold him. You know, I've been like, he's falling. And then I see him nicely, you know, taking a slimy turn and there. That was a picture perfect goal, if you can, you know, put it. It was beautiful. The way he used his body is remarkable. I mean, I don't think the goalkeeper even dreamt of him, putting up that beautiful dodge.
And that was a monumental win, not only for East Bengal, I guess, but whole of Indian football circuit, because going out, going to a foreign nation, winning an international trophy, it can't be substituted by anything. Yeah. And that East Bengal team was so great. They won the NFL that very season, 2003-04, again. So it was a team which was the greatest team, I guess, at that point of time. But as the years passed on, so at that time I was very happy that when your favorite team is on a roll, you will be happy. So I was very happy that East Bengal was winning, because 2005-06 also East Bengal was very close to the title again. And then in the 2006 season, suddenly Bhaichung goes to Mohun Bagan. Oh my God, I felt really bad. This was the second time
he
had gone to heartbreaking moment, literally heartbreaking moment. I never expected him to go. A lot of the East Bengal players of that epic era had slightly one by one gone to other teams. But Bhaichung was the one who went away, and I had a heartbreak. And then came the 2006 CFL Derby. East Bengal was very good at that in that season. Like, they were playing literally, they were winning all the games. And up till the Derby match against Mohun Bagan, they had won a lot of games. Mohun Bagan was struggling on the other hand. Barretto was playing well. But I remember Bhaichung was not clicking at all. And in that match, Barretto was not there. I think he was injured or something. And East Bengal had a lot of chances in that game. Like, it seemed that they would score at any point of time. I remember Asim Bishwas was there. He was hitting the bar and all that. And then came a Bhaichung magic. He scored the only goal of that match, which won them the tie, literally.
Yeah, and it's not about scoring the only goal. You also have to see, it was an offside track, offside trap led by the, East Bengal defenders. He actually used it to his advantage. And then when the goalkeeper Yeah, and then when the goalkeeper attacked the ball, he just quietly, and think of it, how calm he was. He just quietly chipped the ball. He didn't try to hit it hard. He didn't try to do anything extra. Just quietly chipped it, and a beautiful goal. And it was not only a, you know, a fantastic goal. It was also a technically perfect goal, literally.
Technically, jo part hai Bhaichung ka, as a striker, uska sab quality tha. वो सबसे पसंद करता था एहेड बॉल उसको मिलना पसंद करता था उसके अलावा दो विंग से क्रॉसेस आइदर इट इज ए ग्राउंड बॉल और इट इज ए एरियल बॉल ही लव्स दैट काइंड ऑफ बॉल वेरी मच बहुत गोल किया ये विंग से क्रॉस आते हुए बॉल को मिट करके या तो वो फ्लाइंग हेड करता था या कुछ ना कुछ वो करता ही रहता था
वी हैव बीन टॉकिंग अ लॉट अबाउट दिस क्लब परफॉर्मेंसेस व्हिच वर ग्रेट but when it comes to Bhaichung, we can't forget his international matches for India. And I remember till the year 1997, 1998, we used to have those Nehru Cups and all that, multinational tournaments. But what happened after that is those tournaments stopped. For some reason, I don't know. India used to play the FIFA World Cup qualifiers, but those were once in a while. And there was no international football of that stature. In between that. And then from 2007, again, the Nehru Cup started. India won the edition of the tournament. And I remember fondly 2008, there was AFC Challenge Cup. The winner was to be given a chance to participate in 2011 Asean Cup.
Asean Cup.
And India performed really well. Bhaichung and Sunil Chhetri were the main marksmen during that tournament. And I remember the final, it was against Tajikistan. India were leading 1-0, Chhetri's goal. And again, it is a scary scoreline, obviously. Not a safe scoreline. And I remember someone from the wings crossed the ball and Bhaichung was in the box at that point of time. Three players, if you look closely, there were three players surrounding him.
Yeah.
He didn't take one touch. He just half turned and took a shot.
Direct shot.
All the three players were not prepared. The goalkeeper was not prepared. It went straight in the second post.
Right.
That was amazing goal because, like, you need to have that presence of mind that if you would have taken one touch, if you would have taken, he would have been tackled in the box.
Right.
Like, the ball would have been taken away from him. So he half turned and on his weaker foot, his left foot was not his stronger foot, though he has scored a lot of goals. And that was amazing. Chhetri also scored a similar kind of goal after some time, I remember. Same with a left footer from wide, from distance. Amazing goal. That was it.
Yeah, obviously. And, you know, what was brilliant was that the way he scored, it seemed absolutely like he didn't put much of an effort, you know. Actually, when you see the replay of the goal, you realize how perfect the goal is or how beautiful the goal is. Because initially it seemed like, yeah, it's an easy stuff, you know, nobody is covering him. But actually, as you said, there were three people surrounding him. And it's the presence of mind which is perfect. And I have always noticed this, I'm sure most of us will agree on this, that you'll see Orgo, whenever the situation got tougher, Bhaichung actually loved rising to the occasion, right? And he always played the tough games in a very different way completely. He brought his A-plus game to the table.
Hamesha, international match mein he has been successful. Usko ye dimaag mein hamesha shayad rehta tha ke foreign player log ko isko beat karna hai. Ya to uske team mein agar koi foreign teammate ho, usko continuous challenge mein rakhna. Hum log bahut baar dekh chuke Bhaichung. एक्चुअली Bhaichung और बैरेटो एक साथ जब खेले थे हम लोग देखे कि कोई ऐसा नहीं था कि बैरेटो ही मैच जिताया था Bhaichung भी एकदम 50-50 कंट्रीब्यूशन था दोनों का तो ये जो मेंटल एस्पेक्ट है ये मेरे ख्याल से एक प्लेयर को उसका जो डिजायर्ड पोजीशन होता है वो जो हायर लेवल होता है वो टच करने का बहुत हेल्प करता है जो Bhaichung में हमेशा से पहले से था और मतलब लाइफ के लास्ट में आते हुए भी वो
See, as much as we are discussing about Bhaichung today in details, like I have a big regret in my life and that is hurting me a lot. I have never seen a Bhaichung play live in a stadium. And that will be my regret for the entire life, because I remember 2009 I came to Kolkata. I'm not from Kolkata. And that was the time Bhaichung was playing for East Bengal, but a derby match was there. Bhaichung was not playing because he was injured. And after that, he didn't play that much for East Bengal, not in any other derby, not much. And I didn't see him play. So that will be a big regret. I'll not be able to forget it. And as Soumitra said rightly, that he was always performing at par with foreigners. And it was very justifiable to bring a team like Bayern Munich for his farewell in 2012. I remember in 2011 in Asean Cup, that was his biggest tournament by Chung's.
Right.
India didn't perform that well and all that. Like they were out in the group stage. But 2012, he got a good farewell.
Absolutely. And, what I've realized, Orgho, I'm not someone who really likes retirements, because I get over emotional. I always feel that the retirement is not justified. I was not happy with Sachin's retirement. I was, crying when Bhaichung retired. I was sad when Lakshman retired. I was crying when Mithali retired from T20Is, right? So I cannot handle retirements. I'm not someone who can handle retirements. But one thing I agree with you is actually two things. One, I will always have the regret that I have never watched Bhaichung play live. The second thing is live as in from the stadium. Second thing is, this match against Bayern Munich was actually a fitting end to a beautiful career.
मेरे को लगता है बहुत आदमी बहुत कुछ बोलता है भाईचुंग को लेके, उसका डिसिप्लिन नहीं है, उसका ये है, उसका वो है, लेकिन मेरे को लगता है उसका डेडिकेशन, उसका पैशन, जो अच्छा परफॉर्म करना है तो उसके लिए जो करना है वो अच्छा तरीके से करता था, क्योंकि जब प्रैक्टिस में था प्रैक्टिस में 100% एफोर्ट करता है, जब मैच में है मैच में 200% एफोर्ट करता था. तो इसीलिए भाईचुंग हम लोगों का जमाने में सबको छोड़ के आगे निकल गया. हम मेरे को अगर तुम पूछोगे क्या आई एम विजन और भाईचुंग, हम बोलेगा क्वालिटी में आई एम विजन, लेकिन सब ओवरऑल एक प्लेयर का जो क्वालिटी है, जो कमेंडिंग एटीट्यूड है, उसका जो कैप्टनशिप जो क्वालिटी है उसका पूरा था, इसीलिए भाईचुंग सबको छोड़ के आगे निकल गया.
और हम भी ऐसे सबसे आगे निकलना चाहते हैं.
तुम कहाँ आगे निकलना चाहते हो, किस चीज में आगे निकलना चाहते हो?
अरे सब्सक्राइबर्स के रेस में भाई.
Exactly. You guys, like Bhaichung used to blast the net with his shots. Why don't you guys blast the subscribe button?
Aray, wait. Trisha, we have told these guys many times to hit the subscribe button and they are not realizing only. So today the special one will say something special.
आप लोग को ये चैनल अगर पसंद आया तो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और देखते रहिए ये चैनल.
लेकिन सौमित्रोदा और देवजीतदा को तो हम लोग इतना जल्दी जाने नहीं देने वाले हैं, क्योंकि ये लोग कुछ एक्सक्लूसिव कहानियां और किस्सा भाईचुंग के बारे में बताएगा कहां पे, व्यूअर्स कॉर्नर सेगमेंट पे.
ए और को वेट, आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन.
क्वेश्चन फॉर मी और फॉर द गेस्ट?
फॉर द व्यूअर्स. सी, वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट भाईचुंग्स हैट्रिक्स ऑन फील्ड. भाईचुंग हैज आल्सो स्कोर्ड अ हैट्रिक इन अनदर फील्ड. Can the viewers guess which field I am talking about?
Yes, and if you all can guess it correctly, then write down all those guesses on Facebook and YouTube of Sports Addiction. And if you have memories about Bhaichung, you all can share it, you all can make videos of it, you all can write it down and share it on Facebook and YouTube of Sports Addiction.
And that's it for today. So, until next time. Bye-bye.
Bhaichung Bhutia is really something else. He can create something out of nothing, and that is the hallmark of real genius. To conjure up magic, here is the magic. The Romario of Indian football. Out of a narrow opening, he can score the most incredible goals. The most brilliant player in Indian football for many, many years.